Hey guys, what's up? Kane here. I'm going to do a video real quick of some of the anime that I picked up in the past couple of months. I haven't done a video like this, I don't think, ever, really. I did some unboxings of the Fate Zero Blu-ray box sets that I got were really nice, and I did those. And I've been really big into anime pretty much half my life. Actually, most of my life, because my first experience with anime was Voltron when I was about 4 or 5 years old, and I really loved it, but I didn't know till I was in my teenage years in high school that that was actually considered Japanese animation. But anyway, I buy anime all the time, never done a video of it, so I figured, you know, I bought some anime in the past couple months, 3 or 4 months, so I figured, you know what, I'll do a video about it, because I like to talk about this stuff, and I've been talking to a lot of people on YouTube about anime, and it's really cool to have this option to be able to talk to other people, because there's only a few amount of people that I know that live around me, about a handful that are into this stuff, so it's really cool to meet some other people. Anyway, I'm going to kick it off with, you know, what I picked up, and it's really hard to go into order. I'll try to go into order the way I picked them up from how long ago it's been, but yeah, let's just kick it off. First up, I picked up these. I actually started watching the show way back in the day, and I just couldn't get into it. And the box sets are going out of print, so I went ahead and grabbed them when I was in Best Buy, because they're really hard to find. And that is Code Geass Leonch of the Rebellion. This is the complete season one, which is 25 episodes. $30, usually don't like to spend too much, but that's not bad for 25 episodes, so I grabbed it. And I also grabbed R2, which is the second season, which is another, I think, 24 episodes. I only watched the first 2 or 3 episodes of the show, and I just couldn't get into it back when it came out, early 2000. And then my friend kept talking about saying it's really good, and I'm kind of big into mech stuff, so I figured I'd pick it up. Alright, next up, I picked these up a while ago as well, and I know nothing about them. But it looked like something I'd be interested in, because it has medieval stuff, magic, things like that. So I went ahead and grabbed it. And that's the Legend of the Legendary Heroes Blu-ray box set. And this is, I believe, season one right here. And it comes in this cool little case where you can put the season two in there as well. Some kind of edition with tarot cards and stuff. But I haven't even opened it yet. I haven't time. Just like with games, I have to find time to watch this stuff. And this is the, I believe, the first or second box set. I'm probably getting them confused. Either way, I have both seasons. Yeah, this is the part 2. So, Legend of Heroes. I've never watched it before. Looks pretty cool. Could be a total disappointment to me, but looks like something I'd probably like. So, I grabbed it. Next up, I haven't had a chance to watch this, but I did open and watch the first episode, and looks really good. And that is Phantom Requiem of the Phantom. And this is the complete Blu-ray box set. I bought this a while back when it was on sale for about $20-some. It's all 26 episodes on Blu-ray and DVD, so I thought it was a pretty good deal. And it looks, I heard a lot of great things about this show, so I can't wait to actually, you know, sit down and watch it. Next up, I had to get these. These were on sale on Right Stuff a couple months back for $10. And I bought all of them. I used to have, actually, the first 4 volumes, and I sold them a long time ago, and I regret it. And that is Inuyasha. I'm a pretty big fan of Inuyasha. A lot of people don't like Inuyasha, but I love it. So, when I saw these for $10 a piece, and then with Right Stuff's free shipping, I pretty much got all 7 volumes for $70. And that's a hell of a deal, because these are usually about $30. And I really love Digipak, so I was pretty happy to pick these up. But here's season 1, season 2, got season 3 here, let's see, here's the 5th season. I'm actually giving them in order. Whoa, I mixed them up here. This was actually season 1, I'm sorry, this is season 2, and this was season 3. I didn't realize I had them all mixed up. But anyway, that was the 5th one. This is the 6th one right here. I don't feel like editing the video. I'm going to just show them like again. Here's the 4th one. And here's the 7th one. I thought I had them in order, but apparently I didn't. Must have been how I grabbed them. Oh, well. Either way, I bought all 7. Pretty happy. I love digipacks where they open up like that. It's pretty, pretty cool. Next up, another anime series I picked up, and that is a series I never watched, but I saw these for $20 a piece, and I know they're probably going to go out of print soon. And the reason I keep bringing up out of print is because, like most stuff, especially anime, when it goes out of print, it gets hell of expensive. And if they never re-release it, you'll pay an arm and a leg for it. And I don't want to do that. And even though I probably won't watch them for a while, like most of my stuff is sealed, at least I know I have it. And if I ever want to watch it, I won't have to go on eBay and pay crazy scalper prices for the stuff. So I went ahead and picked up volume 1 and 2 of Death Note, because I always heard it was really good. But I didn't want to buy it. But then when I saw it for $20, I went ahead and grabbed them. So, and I buy a lot of stuff on Amazon, so I have an Amazon Prime membership. So I get all this stuff with 2-day free shipping usually when I buy it on Amazon. So it's really nice to have. Especially if you buy a lot of stuff like this and it's the same hobby, it pays for itself. And you don't have to wait forever for it to come in. Alright, next up is something I bought off Right Stuff, because it's only available on Right Stuff. And it's a limited edition, and it's the Durr limited edition Blu-ray box set. You got Celtie on this side, which is really cool. And then on this side, you have that little Beatles Abbey Road look. And this is a really great show. And this is a really cool collector's edition. Basically, it has this aluminum tin. And then you open it up. Boom! And there's your box set. Can't recommend this show enough. I absolutely love it. When I saw it on Blu-ray, I had to grab it. Now, inside here, you got the Blu-rays. And they have, like, really cool art on them of all the characters here from the show. My man right there. And then you also get this cool little collector's book that has concept art, pictures, some information, things like that. So that's really, really awesome. Great music in this show as well. Great voice acting. Not a big fan of the English dub, but the subs is amazing. And then you get this, let me open it really slow, I don't want to mess it up. This pretty cool little poster, which I'll never hang this stuff up. I just like to keep it new. Guess I could frame it if I ever wanted to, but yeah, it's pretty cool. Just nice little extra stuff there that they give you that they don't have to give you. So this is about $150. I couldn't find it cheaper anywhere else, but it's totally worth it. It's a really nice box set. And like I said, if anyone knows anything about anime, for example, Aniplex's Kirin no Kyokai, I just ordered the DVD version, but the Blu-ray versions I missed out on. And it was about $300-$400, but now I think goes for $800-$900 on eBay. So it can get expensive, like I said, when it goes out of print. So I went ahead and grabbed those in Phase Zero before I had to pay those ridiculous prices, because we'll probably never see a Blu-ray release of those. Alright, next up, this is something I've wanted since it came out, but it used to be about $150, $130, so I never bought it. And my friend finally messaged me around Black Friday time and was like, hey, it's $50, you ought to grab it. So I went ahead and grabbed it. And that is the Gunbuster versus Diebuster limited edition Blu-ray box set. This came out a while ago, about 2006, I think. But it's a cool little box set. I bought it mostly for Gunbuster, because I love Gunbuster. And basically what you have in here is you have Diebuster. You have Gunbuster 2 Diebuster, and you have the original OVA movies. It's about, with unaired footage, it's about 6 movies compressed into 1 2-hour movie. But really amazing anime. Definitely recommend watching it, Gunbuster. And it also comes with something I haven't watched yet, but this extra disc. I think it has like interviews, things like that and stuff, so I thought that was really cool. What's also really cool is inside each one of these, it has this really cool, has a map explaining the history of Gunbuster and this little thing. It has little pictures and stuff in it. It's really cool. I really like that they added that in there. So, little history and stuff like that. Great, great show. Like I said, not a big fan of Diebuster, but it's worth it alone just for Gunbuster. Okay. Next up, I'm getting almost to the end here. Something I've been wanting for a while, and it went out of print. And I saw it was coming out on Blu-ray, so I picked up the rights to it. And I was really happy to hear that. And that is Black Lagoon and Black Lagoon 2nd Season on Blu-ray. And this is a great show. Really love it a lot. Done watched about half of it already. Looks absolutely amazing on Blu-ray. So I went ahead and grabbed that. I mean, This was about, how much did I pay for this? About $23, $26. Not a bad deal for 24, 25 episodes, so pretty awesome. And last but not least, I actually usually don't pay this much for movies, but I paid $30 for this. But it's a really good movie, and it's The Children Who Chase Lost Voices. If you're a big fan of Studio Ghibli movies, you'll definitely love this. This is really top-notch, great animation, great storytelling. Don't want to spoil anything, but it's just a great movie. Looks absolutely amazing on Blu-ray, and it was definitely worth the $30. Definitely great movie. Definitely enjoyed it. It's about 2 hours long, so you get plenty there. It's not one of those hour movies or anything like that. So, Makoto Shinkai, I believe, is the director. He did some other movies that are really good, but yeah, had to grab that. Well, anyway, that's it for this video, guys. I hope you enjoyed it. Just thought I'd share some of the anime that I picked up, because I have a lot of hobbies, not just video games and figures. I try to show some of the other stuff. I kind of like to keep this channel just video game related for the most part, because that's kind of my bigger hobby. But anyway, thanks for watching, guys. Talk to you later.